Hey guys, Vikas over here and this is VR Genius. Guys, today I am with a new video around level shifters. So today we'll see how to make your own level shifter circuit using this MOSFET over here. That is the 2N 7000 N channel MOSFET. So why level shifters are at all required? So as you are working on certain microcontrollers, let's say you are working on Raspberry Pi or BBC Microbit or any 3.3 volt logic device, and you are interested to interface with other devices like let's say one port expander or anything that supports 5 volt. Now whenever you are going to transfer data from like one device or the peripheral to your device which is again having 3.3 volt but your peripheral is having 5 volt, whenever the peripheral device transmits data to the main controller which is supporting 3.3 volt, the device will not support it because the signal is again of 5 volt but your device supports 3.3 volt. So this may damage your microcontroller. So for this we are going to need the level shifters. But whenever you are transmitting data from your host device or the microcontroller to the peripheral device, that is 3.3 volt to 5 volt, this is not going to hamper your microcontroller because on the logic side the 5 volt logic will take 3.3 volt as 1, 0 as 0. But whenever you are going to provide 5 volt onto the 3.3 volt device, this is going to damage your controller. So this circuit may be useful if you are working with Raspberry Pi and with other peripherals, or if you are using with any 3.3 volt device lying around. So let's get started guys. So over here I am going to use this device. This is the 2N7000 N channel MOSFET. There are actually many ways that you can create logic level shifters, but for today's tutorial I am going to concentrate upon this particular IC or transistor, you can say, this particular MOSFET. So first we'll see how this circuit is going to work, then we are going to make one and we'll test it out if that works. So the circuit will look something like this. That is having one FET, that is having gate, then this one over here is called as your source, something like this. Then over here this is the drain, and you'll find an internal diode like this over here. So now what we are going to do is we are going to pull up this gate to 3.3 volt, and over here we are going to pull up the source to 3.3 volt 10k with 10k resistor. This one over is the low voltage side, and over here this one is the high voltage side. Now if you are like making the unidirectional one, or if you are going to just use like high voltage to low voltage translation, this circuit will work. But if you are looking for bidirectional, then over here you can use another resistor that is again pulled up to plus 5 volt or the voltage level you want to shift onto, right? So this total over one over here is the your 2N 7000 FET MOSFET actually. Yeah, now let's see how it works. Let's say you are having plus 5 volt over here. Now what happens is this diode over here is reverse biased, and this gate and source voltage over here is 0 volt because over here we are getting 3.3 volt and this gate voltage is 3.3 volt. So net voltage over here is 0 volt. Now this diode is reverse biased, so will not get this MOSFET into conduction mode. So over here what happens, you will get something around through the resistor that is 3.3 volt. So whenever you are using plus 5 volt, that is logic high at the input, you are getting 3.3 volt, that is again logic high at the output. Now as soon as you provide logic low or 0 volt over here, this diode now is forward biased by the voltage 3.3 volt and this over here is your 0 volt. Now what happens is this 0 volt now makes OR with this, and now the gate source junction is 4 hour biased, that is 3.3 volt to 0 volt. Now what happens is, this FET starts conducting. So over here you can see this total voltage drop again drops, and we will get a 0 over here, and this 3.3 volt will drop across the 10k resistor. So we'll get a logic low again. So if you are going to provide low at the low high voltage side, at the low voltage side we are getting a low. If you are going to provide high, we are going to get a high. Now from the low voltage side, if I am making it high, now what happens is my high is 3.3 volt. Now this gate source junction is again not biased, so this FET will not turn on and will get a plus 5 volt or the whatever voltage you are taking is high voltage side over here, so making it high. And whenever you are providing 0 volt, this gate source junction gets biased and this makes the FET on or the MOSFET on, making this drain pin over here 0 volt. That is, whenever you are getting low volt on the low voltage side, you will get a low voltage at the output. So basically you can notice, whenever you are getting high translation, the FET is off. So again, whenever we are going for low to low translation, that FET is turned on. Now let's get back to the workstation and we'll try to solder this one with a perf board and we'll test out the circuit.
So guys, over here the tiny circuit that I have made, that includes the FET or the MOSFET 27000 and two pull-up resistors. One is for 3.3 volt and one is for 5 volt. So over here I am just going to connect it to the power and we will check the voltage translation from high voltage side to low voltage side. So I am just going to connect this 3.3 volt to the gate pin as I told earlier, and I'm going to have an input of 5 volt to the drain. Now I'll just check out, because over here I just connected my multimeter to the common ground, you can see over here, and at the output it's supposed to be this pin. You can see this is giving me the exact output that I require, that is nothing but the 3.3 volt, and for my power supply it's around 3.12 or something. So that means the high translation is working perfectly. Now let's check what happens if I connect it to the ground. So let's connect it to the ground. Just made the ground connections. And over here I'm just going to take the drain pin to ground. So now when I check it output, I get exactly 0 volt. So that means the high to low translation is working. Now let's do one thing. I'll connect ground at the low voltage side. I'll check if I get a ground output at the high voltage side. So yeah. Over here you can see it is giving me exactly 0 volt. That means it is working. So now I'm going to do one thing. I'm going to pull up the high voltage side resistor to 5 volt. Okay. Now I'll connect this low voltage side input to 3.3 volt. So it will be like translating from low voltage side to high voltage side. So when I connect like that, I can get a 5 volt output at the high voltage side. So that means the low voltage input is getting translated to the output, and I'm getting exactly 5 volt. So actually this I have done for testing purpose only. I have shown you the voltage translation, which you can do with other circuits like transistor or your voltage divider circuit. but actual utilization of this circuit is for high speed data transmission. So let's see, if you are working on like I2C, SPA or UART interface that needs high speed data transmission, then your voltage divider or transistor circuit may fail because those are not able to switch at that particular high speed. So this circuit actually will come help whenever you are going to use for high speed circuits. So we'll be using this one for Arduino with ESP8266 module, for which I'll just post in another video. We'll see how to interact with ESP8266 module with the Arduino by using this translation circuit over here, or the logic level converter circuit. So for today, that's all guys. Thank you. Thanks for watching. Feel free to subscribe my channel for latest updates. Thank you.